What's up, everyone? This is Tim from Tim Plays a Game. I traveled back to Kakariko Village. Today we're playing Zelda the Breath of the Wild, sorry. I traveled back to Kakariko Village to get closer to where we gotta go next. I did see a shrine up here. I'm gonna start flying towards it. Last video we were able to recover some of the memories, but I felt like I was getting a little off track, so I should be pretty close to Zora's domain from here. Yeah, so this area right here, this is where we want to get to. But there is a road and a tower I want to activate along the way. So we're just going to drop in a minute. This guy. Oh, crap. Yeah, I exhausted myself. Alright, one down. Not a lot of strength on that spear. Yeah, the spears and the halberds don't have a lot of strength on them. And those were Lizalfos. I'm not sure if we've seen them yet, but they're pretty fast little buggers. Doctus Shrine. And the Sunken Scoop. Okay. First of all, I didn't even know this the first time I did this. But it probably would have helped if I did. There's a bowl down there in the water. So basically, I can do that. Go. That's so much easier. I think I'm gonna grab one. Yeah, I'm gonna grab one of these bolt. Okay. Just drop that in. Oh. Yeah, it's gotta move it onto the big switch. There we go. That opens up. And I think that, yeah, that drains the water. So that would be the end of that shrine, but there is something else they didn't explain, or they didn't, they tried to throw you off. That's the treasure chest in here. Go down here. Now that the water's drained, you can get to it. And here we have the silver longsword. See what I'm gonna drop. Drop one of these clubs. Oh yeah, that's awesome. I'm gonna hold on to that though. I don't wanna use one of my best weapons just yet. And those things can be picked up with your hands. You can move. You can put them in stasis and hit them. Unfortunately, magnets don't work on them. So, but yeah, after that, just run up, get to the guardian, get the spirit orb, and get out. Alright, now that we're back outside, we can keep heading towards Zora's domain. Actually, I think I want to get to there. Yeah. Who is that? You there. Over here, over here. I knew it. You're a Highland, aren't you? Yes, you must be a Highland. Otherwise, you're one unfortunate-looking Zora. Well, your timing could be more perfect if you tried. I was ordered by Prince Sidon to find a highland. I've been searching nonstop. Yes, quite. I certainly wasn't just floating around and splashing in the water for fun. Prince Sidon is a member of the distinguished Zora royal family. He's waiting on top of Nogo Bridge, which is on the other side of that tall tower. I hope you'll agree to go there and meet with him. Ah, yes. You must be taken aback by such a sudden request. My apologies. For Zora, this is our top priority right now. So I must beg you to grant my request. Oh, and if you do meet Prince Sidon, perhaps don't tell him I was splashing about and playing in the water, deal? Alright. So yeah, that's basically our next... So yeah, we'll be heading towards there next. But right now, there's another shrine right here. You know what? I'm going to do a little more hunting. Let's see. See you. And... Dead! Oh! He saw me. I love the little bit of hunting they put in this game. They didn't make it too realistic, thankfully. And by that, I mean it came out as a perfect steak. Right between the eyes. And you get some prime meat for that, too. So it makes way better recipes. Oh, and you see this thing right here? See what that is? You know what that is? Let's run up into it and find out. Yeah, it's a Karak. How'd you see me? I was just a glowing, twinkly light. Nothing noticeable about that at all. Alright, next up is this shrine over here. Hot-footed frog. No beast or no beast, no animal is safe from me. If you ever see, there's the shrine signal. You ever see like a smokestack in the distance? Usually it means there's humans or bokoblins nearby. Can't say which one for sure, but this one looks more like bokoblins. But they also have treasure. Alright. Now if I climb up, they're going to hear me. But if I wait long enough, I might be able... Yeah. Alright. Ow! Okay, don't do that. Let's see. I gotta start doing more cooking. Time to eat some of this seared steak. Ah, dang it. Where are you running to? God damn it, stop running to your friends. Alright. Damn it. Ow. Okay, this is one of the things you really want to avoid. So... Ugh! I hate doing that. Alright, more steak. Actually, tough milk. Oh no, not this. Darn you, Ganon. Friggin' Blood Moon. I think I covered it in previous videos. Blood Moon, basically. So remember all those enemies that I killed? Well, now they're all back. And they're at full health. And I have less weapons. But I have this guy's weapons. Okay, I don't think they have any treasure, so I'm just gonna keep walking. God damn them. God damn them. Alright, I'm taking these two out at least. And you, whistleblower. At least they have good weapons. That's a plus. Yeah, you know what? I might as well take these guys out. There's gotta be some good treasure around here. Yep. At least get some better stuff. Okay. I'm totally gonna sneak up on this guy. Oh, and he's sleeping. How great. Wake up! Go back to bed. Drop this. There's the treasure. Alright, what's inside? Better be good. Eh. That works, actually. Alright, what can I get rid of? Wow, I actually have some good stuff. Get rid of one of these. Alright. To the shrine now. Oh, you there. Over here, I'm over here. I apologize for calling you so suddenly. Yeah. You're one of the Zoras, and you want me to go over to the... Yeah, you want me to go over there. Okay. Thank you for holding my hand. Yeah, I know. I'm on my way, alright? Just... I'm getting there, man. Don't worry. Yeah, No-Go Bridge, Zora River, got it. Prince Sidon. I'll look for him. Alright, I'm gonna climb up here real quick. Hope I have enough to make it. Yeah, I'll climb up here, then I can just parasail down to, paraglide, down to the other, down to the shrine. And look what's up here. Yeah, some of these, I think most of these have these, some of them don't. It's kind of a... And let's see, do I have any fire? I do not have fire arrows, so... Going in. Not gonna make it, okay. So how am I going to get in here now? Well, last time we had fire arrows. Fortunately, I used them all. I think the only real way you can get in is by parasailing in. But this is Breath of the Wild, and your ingenuity will help you immensely. Okay, so those guys are done. Thankfully, there are ways to start a fire. So, let's see. If I should have some. Here we go. So get some flint, get a metal weapon. Ugh, are you kidding me? Okay. Okay, here we go. I know what to do now. Grab some flint. Grab some wood. Crap. All right, hold. Hold, drop. Really? Drop. Okay. Let's try using a less damaging sword. There we go. Okay. Take that. Light it up. Light it up. Just like that. Burns away all the thorns. Or you could have just used a fire arrow or any fire weapons you have. But that's how you get rid of all those thorns. Alright, here we are at speed of light. This one, you gotta be fast. Trying to remember how this works again. Yeah, this thing. Okay, that raises the water up. Yeah, I think by slowly rotating it, it'll make one full cycle on its own. And then it goes around and it hits the crystal again. Which, unfortunately, you have to have it hit again. So it can open the gate or something. Okay, so. So it really doesn't matter which way you turn it. Okay, and all right, and in we go. There we go. And you have to have it lowered again to get this part right here. Barrel on top. Opens the gate. Now I know there's a treasure chest in here, I just can't remember for the life of me where it is. Oh, there it is. Okay. How did I get to it? You know what? I remember now. Okay, I'm gonna get this treasure chest real quick just to show you. So water has to go all the way up again. We're gonna need Krynosis in a minute. Alright, that's up. Now, because that's up, we gotta get in there, so. How did I do this? Yeah, okay, I think I remember now. Yeah, this takes a little bit of, wow. Leave that there. Because I'm going to need it again in a minute. Cool thing is I can leave the bomb there for a good while. And I can just detonate it with L whenever I need it. Man, this is taking a while. So that opens up the gate. So the water has to be down for the gate to open. Remember that. I'm gonna grab this treasure chest, and then I'm gonna grab the second one too. This one has opal in it. Okay. So it has to be down for the gate to open. I'm not gonna be able to get up there from there. So I push it, the water level will go back up, then I detonate, the water level will go back down, then I need to go back up again. Which is why I have the bomb there. Okay, water's going. Water's going. Water is okay. Water should be going back down any minute. Bomb's still there. Water goes back down. Trigger gets pressed. Door opens. Now I go back in. That activates the crystal, that makes the water go back up. I now have Krynosis. There we go, that's how you do it. Alright. That was an ordeal. But I now have a giant boomerang. So everything's good. What can I get rid of? I need to get rid of one of these spears. Alright, and we will get out of here. Alright, and we are back outside. And in the next video, I will be heading towards... Where is it? That tower right there. So stay tuned to Tim Plays Game for future videos. This is Tim from Tim Plays Game signing off. And good night.